I would say at a rough estimate, this batch here of seven would be $50,000 Australian just here.
I've personally invested a substantial amount of money in it. I've probably spent close to $400,000 on Lego.
These markets can rise and they can definitely fall.
Well, I'm actually a fully qualified roof tiler. I've been a roof tiler for 20 years, run my own business for 10. I know they creep some people out with the bug circle, bug eyes and the little blocky nature of them, but more people than not love them. In terms of Funko Pops, the amount of money I've probably put in would be close to 200 to 300,000. I'm also confident in saying that my Funko Pop collection would be nearing $500,000. So the best way to get a return on investing in Funko Pops is to buy low, sell high, like with most things. Typically, I'll sell them probably three or four different places. eBay's always good. Facebook Marketplace is really, really good for selling, and Facebook collector groups. I also sometimes rent a table at a local vintage and collector fair, and I'll sell there. The best thing to do is try and anticipate popular franchises and genres and buy those, and you need to have patience. I think you need to be prepared to sit on those for a while and just keep a really close eye on market trends. This one is one of the most expensive ones that actually exists. It's a San Diego Comic-Con 2011 metallic chrome Spider-Man. The current value on this is about 9,000 US. The reason this Funko Pop is so expensive, you'll see on the sticker, 480 piece limited. So there's only 480 of these made in the world. I take collecting Funko Pops and investing in them pretty seriously. I didn't at the start, it was more just for fun. As I realized there was value to these and people were trading them, I got into it deeper and deeper, and then I really went, okay, this is a full-on thing. So when it comes to Marvel, I've got every Marvel Funko Pop that has ever been released. When I was a kid, my dad was sick and he passed away when I was quite young. And I turned to Marvel Comics. I learned a lot of life lessons from Marvel Comics about responsibility and about doing the right thing and about standing up. And I took that with me through my life. So when Funko Pops started doing Marvel Pops, that was the thing for me.
At the heart of it, Lego investing is a simple process of understanding when Lego is about to retire, buying sets that you think will perform well and putting them away so that you can resell them at a later date and maximise your return on investment by selling it at a premium when demand outstrips supply. So this is where I keep probably most of our long-term hauls, ones that are really close to retirement. We've managed to get bulk lots of from clearance sales at, you know, Costco and Kmart and wherever we can find them. This one in particular I think is going to do really well. It's the Boba Fett helmet. I'm confident that when it retires, it's probably going to double or triple in value. Yeah, it's just a really strong build. The Duplo stuff does really well too. You know, even though they're for little kids, you know, at a $25, $30 price point, when that retires, there are still parents who want them and they'll pay $50 for it. So you're still getting 100% return on investment on something that's, you know, relatively cheap. This set here, I would have liked to have thought it was going to be a really strong performer. It was supposed to retire at the end of this year. So we went out and acquired probably close to 15 or 20 of them. And unfortunately, Lego's announced that they'll be extending the shelf life of that for another 2 years. It's not great for an investor. We'll either have to sell them to make some space and get some cash flow, or hold on to them until they retire later on. About 5 years ago, my wife passed away. My kids were at the time were 14 and 15 years old. I was having anxiety attacks and, you know, my brain was so focused on how much I felt like I was letting people down. And I used Lego because you're so focused on like creating that it kind of just brought some balance to my brain and allows you to try and even momentarily, just to forget about all those problems that you've got. And when you've finished building something, it's this sense of achievement and joy that you've got, I built that, you know, I made that, and I'm not letting anyone down.
I have about 250 vinyl records in my collection, and I actually know exactly how much I've spent. I keep it all in a spreadsheet. I've spent about $5,000 on vinyl records. I treat it as, you know, a serious investment. I'm the CEO and co-founder of a company called alts.co, and we are an alternative investing newsletter, community, and investment fund. What we do is research these alternative investment markets to understand how the assets within the markets are valued. Personally, I think that Funko Pops compare very favorably to something like Legos. Lego sets can cost hundreds of dollars. Funko Pops, usually between $10 and $20 per pop, right? One of the best things Funko Pop packaging did right is how durable it is. With collectibles like vinyl records and, yeah, you know, Lego sets for that matter, it's, you know, a lot easier for the box to be damaged, and that decreases the value. But Funko Pops have sturdy plastic packaging that showcases the pop quite well. Well, there's certainly a lot of dangers in these alternative markets. Unlike traditional markets, where we have decades and decades, if not centuries, of history and regulation, with alternative markets, you often don't have that. These markets can rise, and they can definitely fall. This happened with video games back in 1983, which basically decimated the video games market. More recently, we've seen some markets that have been bifurcated by a crash. So sports cards, for example, the high end is held up, but the low end is completely crashed.
I mean, the floor could fall out on Funko Pop collecting and selling and investing at the drop of a hat for no known reason or for a very good reason. My advice to anyone considering getting into investing in Funko Pops would be, do your research. Like investing in anything, it's not a mug's game. Sometimes there have been mistakes. I've thought this pop will be in high demand, I'm going to load up, and I've bought six of them and been stuck with them and had to let them go for less than what I paid. You got to wear the losses sometimes. I have a long-term plan that one day my kids will take ownership of my collection. They'll be able to sell all of them and buy something that's important to them, something they need, whether it's a house, whether it's a deposit on something, whether it's a car, whatever it is that they need. I'm confident that I'm leaving them with a really, really good investment